Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video bubble chart in Excel, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, today we begin with one more topic on Excel charts, that's bubble charts. Let's begin. Now, bubble chart in Excel is used when we want to represent basically three sets of data in a graphical way. So out of those three data sets used to make the bubble chart, it shows two axes. It shows two axes. Okay. You know, out of the two axes of the chart in the series of x and y coordinates, and the third sets, it shows the data points. So with the help of the Excel bubble chart, we can show the relationship between the different data set. So these charts is basically, you can say, the advanced scatter chart. And it is a type of the data visualization which tells the story of the three-dimension data. Now, every bubble chart in Excel consists of three data sets. X-axis coordinate, Y-axis coordinate, and the bubble size data set. So with the help of the X and the Y, axis, you can visualize the third data set through the image of the bubbles. So in a scenario where we want to use the multiple, we want to use, let's say, multiple bar charts to share results, we can create a bubble and use Excel bubble chart if you want to show your three types of quantitative data set. Now let me get to the example number one to get things started. Over here, what you need to do is, in the step one, you create your own data set and select the data range. Let's say this one. Okay. What you need to do is create your data set and select the range of the data. Here, this one. Let me delete this. Okay. So you need to select the range of the data. Then, post that, just go to insert column. Okay. And in that there will be other charts, and select the bubble chart. Okay, you will have it like this. How about we select the entire thing and then refresh, insert other charts and the bubble charts. So units sold and the profitability that is showing to you. Okay. So, you will get a format x-axis and y-axis data, and you can name it according to the way you want. Okay. You can change things. Even if you want, whatever the way you want, you can change things. Okay. So, finally, your chart should look something like this. I'll change it back to the original one. Okay. An additional point is that, you know, when you move your cursor in the bubble, it will show an entire information, you know, related to that particular bubble. Now, what is the interpretation part of this? Well, the highest sold region is the USA, United States of America. But since we are showing the profitability in the bubble, USA's bubble looks small due to its 21.45% profitability. Okay. So, in this particular regards, it shows the profitability in this region is very low, 21.45, and even though the sales volume is very high when compared to the other regions. The lowest sold region is the Asia, but the size of the bubble is very high. And thanks to the superior profitability level compared to the other region. So this will help to concentrate more on the Asia region and next time due to the higher profit margins. We'll take an example number two. We'll try and understand this in a much more detailed format now. Now arrange the data set, insert a bubble chart from the insert section. Just we'll select a different one this time. Let's get back to the one that we saw before. Okay, so now after selecting this, you know, follow the same steps that was shown that I showed you for the first chart, and you know, it will look something like this. Okay, now what does the interpretation go something? The chart clearly shows that the company EFG, okay, is there in the market for around, let's say, 35, it is here for 35 years, as you can see here, EFG. And their market value is closely around 1575, and their revenue is closely around 350. So company MNO is there in the market for around 20 years, and the last year revenue is closely around 200, and the market value is 988. Right, but the UK is there in the market for around, let's, it's 10 years, and it has achieved closely around 195, okay, as revenue. But in the graph, company MNO size of the bubble is very large. Okay, so, well, that is how things work in this particular chart. And the MNO size of the bubble is very large when you can, when you are compared to the company. Since we are showing the market value in bubble size, we see a massive change in the size of the bubble, even though the revenue difference is only 5. What are the advantages and disadvantages of this? Advantages is that the bubble chart in Excel is a better chart when it is applied for more than 3 dimensions, data sets. For second is, it is more eye-catching bubble sizes, and that will attract the reader's attention, usually appearing it is better than the table format. Some of the disadvantages are, you know, it may be difficult for the first time users to understand very quickly. Sometimes it gets confused with the bubble sizes, and if you're a first time user of the chart, definitely you need someone assisted to understand the visualization. Now, Excel 2010 earlier version adding data labels for the large bubble graph is a tedious task. In 2013 and the later versions, the limitation was not there. The last one is the overlapping of the bubbles is the biggest problem if the two of the more data points have similar X and Y values. But the bubble may overlap or one may be hidden behind the another. What are the things that you should consider when creating a bubble chart? First, you know, arrange the data where you can apply the bubble chart in the Excel. Second, decide which data set that you want to show as a bubble. Like, for example, it happens that first you need to identify the target audience. The third thing is that always use the X and the Y format, access to minimum extent. Fourth, don't look for fancy colors. Remember that, which may look ugly sometime. Fifth, play with the background color as far as possible and of the chart to make it look more nicely and professionally. So that's it for this particular video. If you have learned and liked watching this video, if you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, then like, comment and subscribe the video for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone, and cheers.